This is part one of two from chapter 7, taken from the series Blues for Piano and Keyboard. In this chapter, a new technique for your left hand, made up of only two notes. Just two notes? How can that be any good? Now, here's the secret. They're two really cool notes called the tritone. We'll take the two notes from this tritone, and we're going to use them to build left-hand comp chords that are very simple to play, but they sound fantastic. Today, we're going to talk about a brand new left-hand technique. It's called comping. C-O-M-P-I-N-G. As a piano teacher, this is one of the questions I get the most. What do I do with my left hand? Before we dig into that, let's do a quick review. Listen to this left-hand blues riff from previous blues chapters. Remember that? If you need to, go back and watch through some of the earlier chapters in this blues course. Now let's move into some new territory. Comping. Comping is chords played by the left hand while the right hand plays solo lines. Take a look at this. Notice that my left hand is only playing two notes at a time. This is the simplest comp chord you can do, but it can be nice and funky too. In the upcoming video, watch the left hand. You're going to see lots of instances where it's simply playing just those two-note tritone comp chords. Now the left hand's going to be doing a lot of other things as well, but you'll see lots of occasions where it's simply laying down that two-note tritone comp chord. Now the right hand is going to be doing lots of blues riffs and tricks that I'm going to show you in upcoming chapters, but this is an example specifically to show you those left hand two-note comp chords that are so powerful. Watch for them. Here we go. Did you see them? I played a whole lot of two-note left-hand comp chords. Now let's study how to build them on the keyboard. The two notes that we'll be using to create these left-hand comp chords are the third and the seventh of the dominant seventh chord. Remember, the dominant seventh chord is the number one most common chord used in the blues. Usually, you'll see them written as a capital letter followed by a 7. Now here's a major brain saver. To find the dominant seventh of any chord, simply play a note that's a whole step down from the root. For instance, to find that mysterious note that turns C into C7, first start with the root, which is C, and go down a whole step, which is B flat, and just that quickly, you found that powerful dominant seventh note that can turn C into C7. Now we're putting the seventh down on the bottom of the chord, which is usually considered an advanced technique. But once you know this very simple secret, this advanced technique becomes very easy to do. And you can play that dominant seventh note anywhere you want. You can play it nice and low on the keyboard with your left hand. That's the dominant seventh down there. Or you can play it up high. Learning to do this is one of those very easy to understand musical shortcuts that can revolutionize your playing. Comp chords don't have to be complicated. They're just two notes played by the left hand. Isn't that crazy? Two notes can sound so fantastic. Sometimes, less really is more. Now the right hand is playing a whole lot of stuff, but we'll dig into that in future chapters. Now if you pick two notes in the left hand to make comp chords, it'll sound great. If you pick the right notes, it's just like anything else in life. It doesn't have to be complicated, but it does have to be right. Now the good news is that it's pretty easy to find these two notes. Let's check it out. In our course titled Pattern Piano and Keyboard, which you can find on the net at playpianotoday.com, we studied the two notes of this comp chord specifically, thirds and sevenths. In fact, we went over every kind of seventh chord possible. If you really want to become a creative musician, you really need to go through Pattern Piano and Keyboard.